Hi everyone, I'm Sarah from LSE LIFE and I'm with my colleagues today, Jack and Gio. Hi guys.
Hello.
What we're going to do today is just give you an idea of what a Zoom seminar or class might look like and how to make the most out of this learning environment. So the first thing to think about is when you're in a seminar, it's quite nice to have your camera on so that you can talk to people face to face. It's a little bit more personal. However, we do appreciate that sometimes that's not possible. Gio, I notice you don't have your camera on. Can you put yours on?
Sorry, it's just not working at the moment.
Okay. Well, thanks. We'll see how we go. The other thing you might want to think about, if you've forgotten to tidy your room, for example, me, I've got a big mess behind me, or if you just don't want people to see where you are, you can give yourself a virtual background. The way you do that is go to the little video icon on your toolbar, click on the little arrow next to it, click video settings, and then click virtual background. So underneath my picture, you'll see some pictures that are provided there for you. For example, if I wanted to pretend that I was at the beach, I could do that. You can also upload your own picture. So I've uploaded this picture of my bookcase so that I can look clever in my Zoom calls. Another thing you might want to think about is when you're not speaking, to make sure that you're on mute, just so you don't have any background noise like we just heard. So again, go to your toolbar and there's a little mute button in the corner. And if you click that, you go on mute. So that's quite handy. You could also use a headset, like you can see Jack is wearing at the moment, to cut out background noise, but you need a headset with a microphone so that you can speak. Jack, you had your hand up. Did you have a question? You're on mute, Jack. Jack, you're still on mute.
Okay. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay, good. Just a quick question. Do we have a meeting next Thursday?
Yes, we do. It's at 10:30. But you've just reminded me, when you are in Zoom classes, try to keep your questions focused on the discussion that's happening in the class. And save any questions related to other matters for the appropriate meeting or perhaps an email to your tutor. Gio's here. Your camera's on. Nice to see you, Gio. Thanks for joining us. Another thing you might want to look at is that there are two different views in Zoom. So at the moment we're in speaker view, which means that the person who's speaking is the one who shows up large on the screen. This is quite useful if you're in a big group and then you can see exactly who's speaking at a particular time. Otherwise, you might prefer gallery view, which looks like that, and that puts everyone in the same size frame so you can see everybody at once, which is quite nice too. I'm going to keep it like that because I don't like seeing a huge picture of myself on screen. So you probably noticed when Jack wanted to ask a question, he raised his hand, but he raised the virtual hand. You can do this if you're in a small meeting and then people can see you. But otherwise, if you use the virtual hand, then your tutor gets notified so that they can see you.
I don't know how to do that.
Another reason you might want to do that is in Zoom, it's very difficult to interrupt people politely because what happens is when someone starts speaking, they immediately cut off the other person. So we can't interrupt like we do normally in normal speech. So if you want to speak, it's a good idea to put your virtual hand up. The way you do that is go to your toolbar and click on participants. And you can see near the bottom left of the box, there's a raise hand icon. If you click on that, it will raise your hand so your tutor can see you. Right. Another thing you can do if your tutor asks you a question like, can you hear me? Rather than everyone speaking at the same time, you can use reactions. So again, on your toolbar, go to reactions. And for example, you can click the thumbs up like the chaps have done as well, so that your teacher can see that you can all hear. You might also want to write questions or comments in the chat function. Your tutor might in fact ask you to do this. So again, go to your toolbar, click on chat, and write your message there. You can write the message to everyone, or you can choose to write a private message to your tutor. For example, I'm writing a message to Jack there. Now, just be aware when you are using the chat function that it is a public function. So be careful what you write. Try to keep it polite. So Jack's written a rather rude message about Geo there, which is might upset Geo later. So be careful in the chat function. Another important, very important function of Zoom is that your tutor might put you in breakout rooms. This means a separate group where you can talk in smaller groups. So it's very useful for small group discussion. So I'm going to ask Jack now to put me and Geo into a breakout room so you can see what that looks like. So Jack will do that. In a minute, a box will pop up asking you to join the room. So don't forget to click on that when it comes up. Okay, so here's the box. I'm going to click join. Wait a few seconds. And here we are, me and Geo in the breakout room. Now, when we're here, you might have forgotten the instructions or have a question to ask your teacher, and your tutor's not there to ask, and they can't hear you when you're in the breakout room. So if you want to ask for help, go to the toolbar and click on Ask for Help and then Invite Host. And then if your teacher is available, they will be able to come and join you in your group. So let's hope, here comes Jack. Lovely, thank you, Jack. So then you can ask your teacher a question and then they can leave when you've finished asking your question. Just one final point about Zoom. All of these functions aren't necessarily available on all devices. So if you're using a Mac, for example, or an iPad, you may not have all of this functionality. So do have a play around with those controls in Zoom and see what you are able to do. But most of all, in your seminars, make sure you contribute to the discussion, ask lots of questions about things you don't understand, and try to talk about your own ideas so you can make the most out of the session. And that's all for today. Thanks so much to Geo and Jack for helping me out here. And have a lovely time at LSE. Bye, everyone.
Bye-bye.